Thank you. Girl, what are you doing?
So do you work for anybody? So it's just with no...
That's 21's little baby.
Thank you. talk to me about the scrimmage today versus the Trinity Tigers?
Well, I thought it was a great outing. I mean, the weather cooperated. I think we had some rain coming in, which we'll be blessed to have. And hats off to Coach Drotty and his group. What I was most impressed with them was they played hard, they got after it, but their sportsmanship was off the charts the whole time. I mean, to get through the scrimmage, and that's what we wanted to do. It's a high-intensity workout, and I think both teams got a lot of good out of it. I wish we could scrimmage again next week.
Any surprises for you today, Coach?
I don't really think so. I think at times we look good throwing the ball, at times we look good running the ball. So we'll watch the film. It's never as good as you thought it was, and it's never as bad as you thought it was. We'll break the film down, and we got some good work in today. It was a perfect scrimmage. Nobody got hurt. That's the best thing about it.
In particular, any players, number 12 should look good.
Yeah, well, he should. I mean, he's started for us the last 2 years. He started 27 games for us at quarterback. And I think that's about how many touchdowns he had last year. So he threw for right at 2,000 yards. So we know he can throw the ball a little bit. We've got some really good receivers in Hunter Murray and Petey Little. That quarterback is Lee Holsey. All three of those guys have been two-year returning starters. So,
what are your expectations for this year, Coach?
Well, let me go back to the player guys. On our running backs, we're looking at quite a few kids at running back, trying to make sure we give them all a good look. We lost a great running back last year in Emmanuel Williams, and he rushed for 2,500 yards and 50 touchdowns. And we don't have another Emmanuel Williams, but we have a kid in every class that's competing for that tailback position. And they all look pretty good today. Like I said, we'll break it down. We'll put our gear back on, get some more work in, and then we scrimmage Normandy next week. We're fortunate we have another week. Our first week, we don't have a game, so we have an open week that very first week, so we'll have a little more time to prepare.
And your expectations?
Well, I think if we can keep everybody healthy, that's the number one thing, and then later on keep everybody out here that's on the team that eligible-wise, you know, once you get on into the season, when you hit the district season, you got to battle the eyes in injuries and ineligibilities. And normally that hadn't been a problem for us in the past. You never have control over your injury situation. Last year, that's one of the reasons we were so successful, because we were just blessed on that front. I mean, we went through pretty much the entire year in injury free.
Talk about today, Charles.
Today, man, we showed a lot. We got a few little holes here and there, but we're working on them. We're getting better every day. We're looking good on the field, and I think defensively we're really good.
How'd it feel to hit somebody different color jersey today?
It felt great, man. You know, we got, you know, I ain't gonna call them dummies, but we got our guys, and I like having them healthy, so we enjoy hitting somebody else.
So as a team leader this year, what are you doing to help these youngsters come along and do their thing?
Oh, man, help everybody think they're better than they are. I feel like if you have it in your head that you're better than what you are, then you're going to do a lot.
What do you expect out of the Tigers this year with the new district?
Oh, man, I feel like we'll be pretty good. I feel like we'll definitely be a playoff team. Watch out for us.
Thank you, Charles.
Yes, sir.
Talk to me about today's scrimmage versus Lovelady.
It was a good scrimmage. It's a semifinal team from last year. I felt like we came out really physical, really aggressive. I did some good things defensively. I had a few busts offensively. We kept it simple. We put ourselves in a couple of holes that we were able to work out of. It was a really good practice for us, really, is what happened.
Feel good to finally get against somebody in a different color jersey?
No doubt about that. Yeah, we were glad to not be going against ourselves. I think the kids had the energy that we needed. And I felt like from a conditioning perspective that we were in pretty good shape, so we're going to keep doing what we've been doing. It must be working.
And the ones to watch?
Oh, ones to watch. Obviously, at the quarterback spot, Javonte, we can use him anywhere. If we can get sophomore Brady Bauer to step into a quarterback role, we may be able to use him in some other places, use Javonte in some other places if we need to. Nolan Hodge at the wide receiver spot did a good job, caught some balls up front. Anthony Eaton at the center, Manis, and we got a newcomer at sophomore, a sophomore at left guard, Jeremy Clay, is going to help us out a lot too. So.
I'm sorry, Coach.
No, it's all right. We're excited about what we got.
What about any surprises?
Yeah, Justin Stanley, one of the freshmen we got, he's going to see a lot of reps, a lot of time on varsity, so that was a good surprise to see. And then just overall, our energy and not letting up, you know, when things kind of went bad.
I thought your freshman, young Vault, looked pretty good today.
He did look good. He's got good pocket presence. He'll step up when he needs to. He throws a good ball. So, I mean, he's a guy, and it's one of those catch-22 situations where he's a guy that can push Brady, and they push each other. They'll make each other better, because Javonte's not going to be around forever.
So now you're getting ready for Grapeland.
Get ready for Grapeland. We don't want to look past that. It's going to be another scrimmage, another practice for us, and we're going to start preparing for Crockett.
Coach, the Lions commend you on your sportsmanship. You thought your team had exceptional sportsmanship out here today.
Absolutely, and Lovelady as well. You know, we're close, 14 miles down the road from each other, so like most of these kids know each other. And so to see that out here, and then the guys talking to each other after the game, that's positive, and that's what it's all about in the end. It's just you know, playing hard against each other when the whistle blows, and then understanding we're all in this together after it's over.
A lot of good hitting today, Coach.
Yes, sir. Yeah, it was. It's fun to watch.
Appreciate you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Can you talk to me about the scrimmage today against Lovelady Lions?
It went pretty well. Went better than expected. We had a couple people come out and watch us. Had a good vibe going.
When you say better than expected, kind of elaborate on that for me, Javonte.
This year is supposed to be our down year, and we're looking a lot better than what anybody would have predicted or expected.
Is that used as a motivating factor for you?
Yes, sir. We always like to play with a chip on our shoulder and keep going, grinding every play, every day.
What are you doing to help the youngsters out?
Just give them a little guidance from what I experienced and what I've learned from my upperclassmen.
What do you expect out of yourself this year?
All-state at D1.
As usual, right, baby?
Yes, sir.
Talk to me about next week versus Grapeland, what you're going to be looking to do.
Just execute perfection, getting multiple reps, keep going strong.
Pushing your teammates and being a leader.
Yes, sir.
What about the youngsters? Who are you kind of taking under your wing and kind of working with?
All of them, really, but Justin Stanley, he's coming along, Caleb Rowling, Holden Hodge, little guys like that.
Talk to me about being a quarterback. How different is that going, you know, taking the ball from the center?
Ooh.
As opposed to George Vaught.
It's a different world.
It's a
different world.
How so?
I mean, it's different from being from right next to him to actually taking the snaps. But
well, I thought you looked good, man. I thought you looked real good.
Thank you.
Talk to me about passing. How you learn to pass like that?
Oh, back before I started playing, me and my mom would go out and play catch in the yard.
That was a sweet pass to Hodge in the corner there.
Yes, sir.
Or six. So yes, you're going to be your go-to guy pretty much?
Yes, sir.
Him and who else?
Him and Fred Rogers, senior slot receiver, and Caleb Rogan.
And, of course, being a safety on defense, I know you're the best tackler in the district last year. Yes, talk to me about that. Now you got a little more room to roam back there.
Yes, sir. It's a lot more open, a lot more wide. I get to show my true speed now.
I hear you, man. Congratulations on today. Good luck in Grapeland.
Thank you.
All right, my man.